What's going on, everybody?
Well, I'm sure you heard from the little introductory walk into the pit here. Gapra's got an outrunner. Just like what I did with the base camp, we're doing final preparations for Axial Fest. And the Gapra was awesome as it was brushed, but I've always had plans of putting a revolver in here, but I decided to go a little bit of a different route. So not much has changed on the outside, but the inside did a complete electronics overhaul. Everything is new. So what we got here is a Sidewinder 4 ESC, and then we have got a, let's see if I can get you in there very well or not, got a 9 iMod. It's a 1850 KV outrunner. I'd seen a few videos of people running those and having decent luck, so as cheap as they are, I figured I'd give it a shot. And then for steering duties, I went ahead and put my Three Brothers RC G14 servo. That's a direct power servo in there. I believe on 3S it's supposed to be around 750 or 800 ounces of torque. It's a pretty beastly little servo, that's for sure. And then I went ahead and put the Fly Sky radio in here. So I think after I do the bomber teardown and rebuild here tonight or tomorrow, the only truck that is not going to be on my Fly Sky radio is going to be my 6x6. And since that's my tow rig, I kind of want to keep that on its own remote so that I can run multiple rigs at the same time, like I do every now and again. But yeah, I think that is about it. I just wanted to bring it out after I got the electronics put in it and make sure everything's driving all right with everything else. So honestly, I'm just doing a little shakedown run tonight. It's going to be pretty damn noisy, obviously, so probably won't be much talking here unless I stop and talk about something. So if you got headphones on, turn them down. Watching it on the TV or something, you still may want to turn it down. We're going to have all kinds of sci-fi noises here. But it's still pretty muddy. We got some more rain last night, so it's even muddier than it was yesterday when I had the base camp out here. So there's a few lines I may not even try to attempt, just because I don't really want to get this thing all muddy and then have to clean it up again for next week. But we'll see how she does. Thank you. got debris. Them critters and chewed up my path again. All of these holes, try to get a better angle here. All of these little critter holes around the gravel pit here after Axial Fest, they're getting filled back in. We're gonna have some heavy equipment videos. That ought to be fun. I really don't know if this one's gonna happen today. I don't know, sorry, I got mosquitoes all over me. I'm kinda moving around here. I don't know how well it comes through on camera, but these concrete pieces here, they have a nice coating of moss on them. And then over here on this side where the critters have pushed a bunch of mud and dirt down in here, my tires are just caked in mud. I see that little undercut right there is where my back tire was getting hung up. I do not believe that rock was there before. I'm pretty sure that it was up in that hole. Might be where I'm having some issue here. Honestly, I'm not too concerned about whether it'll make it today or not. I know that this truck will do that no problem. Man, I'm not sure what happened here. We'll just see if that makes any difference or not and then move on. Thank you. Well, I think that if I actually tried for a little while, I'd get that, but I don't want to put you guys through all that, so we'll just move on. Here I said I wasn't gonna take this thing through the mud and get it all dirty. We are pretty well caked up. It is way nastier up here today than it was yesterday. I'm having trouble standing on barely even a hill at the bottom here. Quite have enough wheel speed to clear the tires out, so it looks like we're just gonna keep adding to it. If this gives you any frame of reference on how muddy it is, that ought to explain at least a little bit why I'm having issues with the truck today. That is mud. That isn't cow poop this time. Thank you. thought I could keep it there for a second and spin all the mud out. I'm curious if it'll climb this wood spiral staircase here with all that mud on the tires. It's gonna make things really slippery. The wood's still kind of wet in some spots too. This spot right here is the hardest spot. Hold on, gotta readjust my camera here. Getting up in the higher elevations. There we go. But yeah, this transition right here is always the hardest spot on the staircase, even on a dry day with no mud. Too far. There we go. I know that the super slow crawl probably makes for some boring video, but man, I really like how slow this thing can go. Outrunners are just awesome. It's hard to hate on that kind of control. Thank you. There's a good way to clean the tires off. I think I might actually have to turn the drag brake down a little bit. I'm afraid I'm going to end up breaking something with this thing. It's a little dangerous for my footing over here on this stuff. I gotta kind of watch where I'm going. Yeah. That didn't sound good. That may have been a portal gear. I'm not 100% sure. Bound up pretty good there, that's for sure. Let's see here. What is it? Well, the drive shaft isn't spinning. So I think that's something in the transmission. Well, that's a heck of a way to end the video. Either way, I'll look into it and see what's going on. I've got a spare transmission for it anyways, so if it is the tranny, no worries. Or I can just swap whatever gear tore up. I'll get her figured out. She'll be ready for Axial Fest. I think the only other thing I was curious about was the heat on the differentials. Not an issue. It's just got quite a bit of overdrive in there. The one time that I actually trail ran it kind of around the pit with the brushed setup in it, that front differential actually had some pretty decent heat in it, but that was running pretty well full bore for 10 or 15 minutes. But everything's cool now. I'm happy with it. I'm really digging this motor ESC and servo combination that's in there, especially once we get a nice dry day again. This thing's gonna be a monster on the rocks. I'm really looking forward to that. But I think that's gonna do it for today. It's not much more I can do with a stripped out gear, a mystery stripped out gear. I hope y'all enjoy. If any of y'all are going to Axial Fest and you see any of my trucks running around, stop by and say what's up. Check them out. I'd like to see what all you guys are working on as well. But that'll do it for me today in the pit. Hopefully tomorrow or Sunday or Monday, I don't know, sometime this weekend, hopefully I'll get the bomber done and I'll have a final update video on that as well. So stick around. That one will be interesting. But I suppose I will catch you all in the next one. Thanks for watching.